Welcome to GemWebLog. In this video, we are going to discuss about J radio button event handling using item listener interface. So when you discuss about item listener interface, it contains a single method, item state changed, which receives the object of item event class. So when you talk about item event class, it contains four methods: get item, get state change, param string, get item selectable. So get items, it will return the items that is affected by this event. Get state change means it will return the type of state that is getting changed. Whenever it is selected, it will return selected constant. If it is deselected means it will return the deselected constant. Param string, it will return the string which contains all information about this item event. Get item selectable, which will return the object who originate this event. First, you have to import java.awt.event package. Next, what we are going to do means we are going to create a button which contains two arguments, swing and an image icon. What we are going to do means we are going to align this text with respect to images. Left, right and center alignment is going to perform. For this, we are going to create three buttons. Whenever the left button is clicked, okay, the text will align left side of my images. Whenever the right radio button is clicked, okay, the text will be aligned right side of my images. Whenever center button is clicked, both text and the image will align at the center. Since this is a radio button, we have to create a radio group, okay, so such that we can able to select only one option from the given options. So first we are going to create radio button along with the button group, and we have added into the frame. Next, for demonstration purpose, we have created a button two parameter, and we are going to create a button with two parameter, string and an image icon. Now we will see the layout of the component first. Now you can able to see a three radio button and a button. Whenever I press left, the text will align left side of my image. When I press right, the text will align right side of my image. Whenever I press center, both image and the string will align at the center of the button. So first step, we have to register the radio button object with the corresponding item listener interface. So why you have to register means whenever the item event occurs, it will detect it and it will pass this to the method. So le.addActionListener. We are going to add for the other button also, for right button RI and then for center button CE. So inside the item listener, we are going to define the object for item listener interface. So inside this, we are going to define the method public void item state changed, which receives item event object. Okay, so inside this, we are going to perform the various tasks using item event methods. So before we enter into it, just we are going to replicate the same code for. First method is get item. Now we are going to receive which item has been selected. Okay, if whatever the object that we are defined, it will extract it. Now inside this left, radio button event handling, if I say that if I press LE, that is the object of this radio button, means I'll align my button DE with horizontally with respect to left. Same I'm going to do when I'm pressing the right button, means RI, means I'll align my text with respect to image on the right side. Same thing, if I press center, I'll align my string with respect to image center of the text. Now we will see left, the text is aligned left side of my image. Right, it has been aligned at right side. Center means both image and the string has aligned at the center of the button. Next we are going to see the next method, get state change. So it will extract the state of the given object. Whether if it is selected means it will return item event dot selected constant. If it is deselected means it will return item event dot deselected. Now same operations, instead of comparing with the object name, we are going to compare with the selected constant value. For this we are going to extract e dot state change. So whenever the corresponding radio button is selected mode, okay, the corresponding operation will take place. So we have compared with the object name. Here we are comparing with the selected option. So here when the left button is selected, okay, the string will align with the right side, left side of my image. Whenever the right is clicked, it will align right side. Center means both text and the image will align at the center of the button. Next we are going to look into the get item selectable. So here it will return the object name. Okay, whichever the object is selected, it will return the object name. So first we will, whichever the object is in selected mode, it will return it. So with respect to the object name, we are comparing. Here again we are comparing with the object. So here we are getting the object name, then object name equal to LE means left option will be selected. Again we are doing it for right. So we are going to compare with right. Next with respect to center, center we are comparing. Left, left alignment, right, right alignment, center, it has been aligned at center. If we want to extract all the information of the particular event means e dot param string will extract the information. Since I have put inside the left event handling method, whenever the left button is pressed, okay, it is extracting all the information with respect to the particular event. The value. Thank you.